Myself, Mr. Giridhar Jain, Assistant Professor in Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now today I am going to explain you programming of interfacing with microcontroller 89C51 with switches and 7-segment display. Now learning outcomes. Learning outcomes of the session are, at the end of the session, students will be able to write assembly language program for interfacing circuit for 89C51 with switches and 7-segment display. And second outcome is students will be able to write assembly language program for interfacing of stepper motor. Contents of the session are program for interfacing of switches and 7-segment display and program for interfacing of stepper motor. So this is the interfacing circuit for switches, LEDs, relay and buzzer. And this is the circuit for interfacing of 7-segment display. So here common anode 7-segment displays are used, 4 displays are used as shown in figure. So this is PNP transistor, so this is a digit driver circuit. So these are the 4 digit driver circuits and they are driven by P0.4, port 0, line number 4, 5, 6 and 7. 7 segments of all the displays are, means for example A of 4 displays is connected together, B of all is connected together, likewise. So they are driven by BCD to 7-segment decoder 7447. This is BCD input. So BCD input is taken from P0.0, P0.1, 2 and 3. So port 0, lower 4 lines are used here and port 0, upper 4 line are used for digit driver as shown in figure. So interfacing of 7-segment display. Write a program to check whether interfacing circuit is working correctly. So think on the solution of this problem, that is how to check correctly the working of interfacing circuit for 7-segment display. So circuit already I have explained to you and we have to write a program to check this hardware. Now for checking this interfacing circuit of 7-segment display, select one display at a time and display 0 to 9 with a delay. So in this way we can check all the that 4 7-segment displays and repeat this procedure for remaining 3 displays. Now for example, select display 1 and display 0 on it. So what bit pattern should be outputted at port 0? So output pattern to port 0. So 0, 1, 1, 1 means this 0. So this display is selected. So display 0 is selected. So and here output 0 means 0, 0, 0, 0. Means output 70H to the port 0. It will select display 1 and output 0 to the display 1. Similarly, let us select display 2 and output 0 to that display. So we have to output a pattern 1011000, that is B0H. Similarly, for selecting display 3 and displaying 0 on that display 3, we have to output 1101000, that is D0 to port 0. So this technique is being used to output the required digit, required BCD digit on the required display from display 0 to display 3. So interfacing of 7-segment display programming .org000h sjump st .org0040h jump to start as usual. Clear P1.4, row 1 is active. Means we have to start executing this program. Means we have to start checking the display if switch S1 is pressed. So jump if bit P1.0, check if SW1 is pressed, then move R7 immediate 0AH, immediate 0AH means set the counter. Counter is set for 10, move R6, 70H. So bit pattern require to select display 1 and output 0, that is move R6, 70H. Then move R6 to A. R6, content of R6 is moved to the accumulator, and then accumulator is moved to the port 0. Move A to P0 means display 0 on display 1. So this action is taken by this instruction. Now once 0 is displayed on display 1, A call delay. Delay for 1 second. Increment R6. Increment counter. Decrement and jump pip no 0 DJNZ R7 to DN2. So this process is repeated till after 0, 1 is displayed, then 2 is displayed, 3 up to 9. After 9, this loop will be over and it will go to the next line of the programming. Then move R7, 0AH means we have to select display 2 and output 0. Again move R6, 0B0H, this is that bit pattern, and this is 10 initialization counter. DN3, move R6 to A, A to P0, A call delay, increment R6, DJNZ, R7 to DN3. So by this program, display 2 is checked for displaying 0 to 9. Move R7, 0AH, repeat for display 3. Same program is repeated for display 3. Then we have to repeat the same program for display 4. So move R7, 0AH, move R6, 0EH. So this is the bit pattern to select display 4 and output 0 to that display. And this program is the same which we have done earlier, only the labels are changed. So in this way, so here DN6, yes jump DN6, wait in a loop. Means after checking display number 1 to 4 and displaying 0 to 9, this program will wait in a loop. So this is a delay routine. So this is a software delay. So here register R0, R1 and R2 are used. Move R0, immediate 0AH, delay routine for 1 second. Then B1, move R1, 0FFH, B2, B3, DJNZ, R2 to the B3. Then DJNZ R1 to the B2 and DJNZ R0 to the B1. So this is a delay routine. So in this way we have checked 4 7 segment displays are working and whether the program is working. Now next is write a program for interfacing of stepper motor with the facility to increment the speed if S1 is pressed and decrement the speed if S2 is pressed, and stop the motor if S3 is pressed. Think on solution of this programming task. This is interfacing circuit for matrix keyboard, LED, relay and buzzer. So we are using the switches for increment and decrement the speed, and we are using the LEDs for output, which can be used further with interfacing circuit to drive a stepper motor. So this is P2.0, 1, 2 and 3. So these port lines are used for stepper motor. Program. So .org00h, sjump st, .org0040, move R0, immediate 77h, load the starting pattern, means one line of the stepper motor, here one port line is made 0, 77. Clear P1.4 row 1 active. So row 1 is made active to sense, to check whether switch S1 or S2 is pressed. Move R1 08H, load delay for default speed S1, move R0 to A, that is read pattern, pattern is read 77, then rotate left, RLA, rotate left, move A to R0, that output that pattern to here store in R0, move A to R0 is save. Then ORLA immediate 0F0H, so mask the MSD, move P2.1, move A to P2, that is output at port 2 to activate the LEDs, A call delay. So move A to P2, output at port 2 and A call delay. Means first bit pattern is outputted at port 2 and then delay is call. Then jump if bit P1.0 to DN1, check if S0 is press. If S0 is press, we have to decrement R1 to increment the speed. So DEC R1, which will increment the speed. Then DN1, jump if bit P1.1 to DN2, check if S1 is press. So we have to decrement the speed, therefore increment R1. DN2, jump if bit P1.2 to DN3, check if S2 is press. Move R0, immediate 0FFH, stop the motor. Means if S2 is press, we have to stop the motor. DN3, S jump to ST1, means wait in a loop. Then this is the delay routine. So .org 0100H, this is the address of delay routine, and this is the delay routine, similar delay routine which we have used in the earlier program. So move R1 to A, so R1 is incremented or decremented for variation of speed, and move A to R2, and then this is standard delay routine. So these are the references. Thank you for watching this video.